Hi friends, this is Anna with Scrapping, Stamping, and Stuff, and this week we are scrapping. I was lucky to get to go to a retreat this past weekend. We were actually allowed to have it and do some scrapbooking and card making, and it got me in the mood to share some scrapbooking ideas since it's been a little while since I've done so. So I'm using some of our new products in our new January through June Stampin Up mini catalog. We have some really neat stuff in this catalog, and this is such a pretty stamp set. We do have a coordinating die set, but for this real simple page I'm going to make today, I'm just using this Pretty Perennial stamp set. Now, I'm going to be honest, when I first saw this set, it did not catch my eye. I have a lot of other floral sets. Sometimes I wonder how many floral sets I need in my collection. It didn't catch my eye. And then I saw this set demonstrated, and I saw some really neat projects made with it, and I was hooked. So let's look at what we're going to create today. I've done a lot of the prep work, as you can see. Basically, we're going to stamp this floral pattern on the background, add a nice pretty floral border over top, add a couple of embellishments, and that's going to be it. But I'll show you, many of you probably know this. This is not rocket science, but to create a nice background, you can choose any image and repeat it multiple times. To get the faded effect that I created here, I stamped one time, I stamped a second time, and I'm going back and forth, as you can see, to create the staggered effect. But that is how I got the faded look, and I use this a lot on my projects. So that's called stamping. I'm sorry, stamping off is where you stamp on a scrap paper and then stamp to get a faded one. This is, you can call this several different things, like multiple generation stamping, where you stamp a few times to get those different colors. Now I have a border created here, and this piece was 2.5 inches wide. This piece is 2¾ inches wide, and I've already done a lot of the stamping to get this really pretty floral pattern here. So if you look at the stamp set again, you can see there are just tons of flowers in here, and I've only used a few of them. There are quite a few more that I haven't even used, but I stamped that happy, which I love, with black ink. And for cards or scrapbook pages, you can pair it with these other stamps for different combinations. So happy mail, happy for you, happy birthday, you make me happy, sending lots of happy. So I thought about using one of those. I decided for the scrapbook page just to leave it as happy, and it could work for all sorts of things. So I've stamped the large flowers with Daffodil Delight, this flower with Melon Mambo, the small ones with Bermuda Bay, and the leaves with Granny Apple Green. Now I am going to use the leaf fill-in stamps. I have the large one and the small one, and go back over to fill in those leaves with this. So this is a nice way to get some extra color and dimension on these leaves with the two-step stamps. So there, I think I have all the large ones filled in. Now we'll do the smaller ones. And I debated which flowers to use on this. I just love all these stamps, and I decided to keep it simple. I thought about continuing to add some more of the different stamps and more colors, which I definitely could have, but I decided I liked the white space that was left. I decided I did not want to fill in all of my white space. So there was no rhyme or reason to where I put my flowers and my leaves. I just started stamping and ended up with what you see right here. Now, I probably have some ink on my surface, so I'm going to clean it off with my chamois real quick. The next thing we can do is go ahead and attach this border to the matted piece that I cut for it. Then we can attach this to the page. So we'll leave just a little border along the edge. If you are hearing background noise, this is Christmas break. So we have four children at home who who are excited to be here, and we are excited to have them here for a little while. Get to spend some quality time together when things aren't so busy. All right, so we'll get that attached right here. I decided I wanted to add a bow, so I have a little bit of ribbon here. And if you have not seen this trick, I thought I'd show you where you can tie a bow on your fingers. So if you want more detail or more instruction on this, look up my video, 10 Tips to Tie a Perfect Bow. But you begin with a little tail over here, wrap it around to the back, all the way around back to the front. You're going to push it down through the center of your fingers, underneath, bring it around up top. Tie that into a knot and pull it tight. And we have a perfect little bow. So I'm going to trim the ends off of that a little bit. Like I said in my other video, I spent a lot more time explaining that and lots of other tips. But that is a really handy tip for being able to tie nice bows if it's something you struggle with. I'll put a glue dot on the back, the center of the bow. Add it over here. And I debated what embellishments I wanted to add, and I decided to go with these gold glitter enamel dots. I think they blend in really well with the Daffodil Delight color here, the yellow. And I also debated where I wanted to put these, but I think I'm going to stick with them just on my border piece, just in the centers of the yellow flowers. And that is just so pretty. I love the bright colors. I love the flowers. You could use this for anything. Springtime, summertime, special occasions, all sorts of things. So remember also, you can apply these same ideas to other stamp sets that you have, other floral sets, other sets of anything. It could be balloons or it could be dogs. You can use this exact same page recipe, stamp some of them on the background, fill up a border piece with it, add a few embellishments, and have a cute page in any theme. So thanks for joining in today. You can get more ideas and inspiration on my blog at scrappingstampingandstuff.com. In the video description, you can find a link to my blog with links to order all of the products that I showed here today. I hope you have a wonderful day, and I hope to see you again next time.